That's my boyfriend, Peter. He has Crohn's, a type of inflammatory bowel disease. If you know anything about it, you know that it's a pretty shitty way to live. Peter's been really sick for the last year or so. It's sucking the life out of him, and I have no idea what to do at this point. You're going to the bathroom 10 to 20 times a day. You're in constant severe pain in your gut and your joints. Imagine watching your boyfriend crawl into his bed in excruciating pain, to the point where he isn't talking. Now imagine that after you'd just been throwing up because the pain was too much. And now you're scared. Because this is something he'll have to deal with for the rest of his life. There is no cure.
When I first found out he was sick, I didn't actually know what Crohn's was. I decided to make this documentary to learn more about his disease, and to document my journey with Peter so that others can learn more about it too.
Thank you so much for meeting with me.
Yeah, glad to.
All right. I was hoping you could basically tell me just what IBD is and what the difference between Crohn's and colitis is.
Sure. So inflammatory bowel disease is an umbrella term that we use to categorize Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. And so it's a problem of inflammation in the gastrointestinal tract. Inflammation really just means red and sore and swollen. Crohn's disease can affect really anywhere from your mouth all the way to your bottom, and usually in a patchy kind of way. It can affect the entire thickness of the wall of the gastrointestinal tract. Where ulcerative colitis really just affects the colon or large intestine.
Within 4 months of meeting each other, we were in the hospital together for 5 days. So she got like the crash course.
It was still very early in our relationship. You're still kind of in the honeymoon phase, getting comfortable with someone. And then we're in the hospital together, and the nurse comes in and kind of like looks at me, and I can tell she's a little bit like, how comfortable is this guy with this girl? Okay. Mm. And she's like trying to gauge it a little bit. And then
she was cool.
She was really cool. And basically she starts asking all of these questions that like, I felt bad because I felt like you were probably like, would have been so uncomfortable. But she's like, are you passing gas? Like, how's like your butt? How's like all this, like all these questions. I felt bad because I'm like, oh, this poor guy. Like we like are just like getting to know each other. And then like, you have to, I don't know. We have to get to know each other It's just something you wouldn't normally want to be asked in front of your new girlfriend. I just thought it was funny.
I was diagnosed when I was 16. I was in grade 11 and I was sick for like a year straight. And we didn't know what was going on. So I was told that I had celiac first, then it was like different food allergies, then IBS. Then eventually they decided that I had Crohn's. So that was cool. Then I got sent to my GI. He confirmed that I had Crohn's.
The first time he told me he had Crohn's, the first time he didn't actually tell me he had Crohn's. He basically said he had like a lot of dietary restrictions. So, I remember he was coming to my place for a party and I'm like, okay, what can he eat that doesn't have milk in it? First he told me he was lactose intolerant, which isn't even true, really.
It's true.
Yeah, but it's not what... Anyway, so he told me he was lactose intolerant. So I'm like, oh, I have lactates. Perfect. You can eat whatever you want. And then he's like, well, no, I actually can't have milk. So I'm like, oh, so I made all these things with no milk in it. And then I was like, yeah, he's allergic to milk. And then he's like, well, like, actually, I have Crohn's. And I was like, oh, what's Crohn's?
What Crohn's is so depressing. So, I was 16, right? And it's literally your body attacking itself. So it's like, my body is committing suicide and I don't want to die. So it's not a fun thing to be told that you have. It got to the point where the reason why I started going to the gym, like for health reasons, was I couldn't sit in a chair anymore because I didn't have the muscle, like any muscle mass to support myself. So if I sat in a chair like upright, my back would just die. Like it hurts so bad. And the doctor told me to like, that I wasn't allowed to do anything strenuous at all. So I started going to the gym. You do miss out on a lot. Like I don't drink, period. So when we go out to bars and stuff, like I'd rather just not go. It's weird. I'm so adjusted to it now because it's been like 5-6 years or whatever. So it's the new normal they talk about. Like, yeah, you miss out on a lot, but like, I'm used to it now. Biggest example is we had a Florida trip this summer, and I was in the hospital for it, so we didn't go. So that sucks, but whatever. It happens.
Basically, we were supposed to go to Florida, and then we had to cancel. And I remember, like, right after that, Peter said something along the lines of, like, what did you say? He basically said, I feel kind of like a burden, and he said that this whole getting sick and having to cancel plans thing doesn't happen all the time, but it could happen anytime. So he said, are you sure you want to put up with that? And I was like, yeah.
So basically, we're going to press start, and then it's going to be like, Hakuna Matata, and you're going to be like, it's from The Lion King, and you can't say Hakuna Matata, but you can say anything else. What's another word for a feeling?
Emotion.
A, like, tingling, or a...
Sensation.
Yeah.
They stand at schools and they help people.
Crossing guard.
Yeah.
Damn. How do you are so I saw it. Press
nice. A car... A place where they work on cars. Never mind.
A car...
We've canceled a lot of plans this past year. Which is fine. I mean, when he's in pain, I'd rather him be at home where he's at least somewhat comfortable. We do take advantage of the good days, though. Oh, that's my friend Celine, by the way. She has Crohn's, too. When I found out, I wanted her to meet Peter so bad. He doesn't know anyone else with this disease. I guess I just wanted him to know that he wasn't alone. Celine's situation is a little different than Peter's. She's exhausted all treatment options and had to get a life-changing surgery. Now she has an ostomy, something Peter could need in the future. I want to learn as much about it as possible.
So I was diagnosed with actually colitis when I was 8. I was really young, so I don't really remember much about that whole period of time when I was being diagnosed. I just remember like one day being fine and the next day like going to the bathroom like 20 to 25 times a day. And my parents did not know what was going on, so took me to a GI specialist.
I mean, we've learned a lot from her. Resilience is one thing that we've learned a lot. She's like, she just rolls with the punches, and, you know, nothing stops her, right? So based on that, we have learned a lot from her. And she's a fighter, there's no doubt about it. And she's amazing, like, you know, nothing stops her for doing what she wants to do. You know, her I remember when she was younger, when there were school trips, I used to drive her all the way there to the camp because she might have to go to the bathroom in the middle and the buses don't stop, right? So I actually drove her all the way north so she couldn't miss any of the trips, and she was part of what she needed to do. So we made sure that her disease didn't stop her from doing what she wanted.
As soon as I did the surgery, like after like 3 months, I gained like 30 pounds. I like shot up, had like all of my energy back, which was great. But it's also like I was 16, and like having like a bag on your stomach like is not exactly the time of your life when you wanted when you want that to happen. Not that there's like a good time for that to happen, but I kind of like saw how much better I was feeling compared to what it was before, and kind of dealt with it and realized that it was actually like a really good decision.
She showed me how to change it a while ago, a few months ago at least. And she just told me all the different parts of it really and how she changed it.
I'm pretty open about it with most people. I feel like it was just like, I don't want to overwhelm him with information like all at once.
Slowly slip things in?
Yeah, just so like I told him, I think I told you I had Crohn's like pretty like near when we met, like probably on our first or second date.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, I felt like that was like, okay, let's ease him into that first and then we'll see.
I just blame myself sometimes. I don't know.
There's nothing we can do, right? That was the hardest part. And still the hardest part, right? Even telling her to try new things or anything like that, or try some home remedies. There's nothing with that, right? So it's kind of hard. It's really hard.
Yeah. Changing diets and
or not being able to eat.
The scariest thing is how fast things can change. The night was actually going pretty well for a while. It was Christmas Eve, the night before my family left for Mexico.
Wow, it's really nice. May this season bring you closer to all those you treasure in your heart. Did you guys write this?
No.
Have a Merry Christmas. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We were sleeping, and all of a sudden, Peter was on the edge of the bed. Then he was throwing up. I'm usually not around when he gets really bad. It was the first real glimpse I got of what our future might be like.
You could hear it in my whole house, like, just him throwing up. And, like, my family's trying to, like, get ready, and they're all, like, you know, running around, being really loud. I was kind of, like, freaking out and stuff, and, like, just, like, frozen. Like, I didn't know what to do. At the end of the night, like, I brought him downstairs because it was, like, you know, quieter. And then I was like, okay, do you want me to go? Like, I'll go back upstairs. He's like, no, stay. And I felt so relieved because, like, the hardest thing ever to do when, like, someone's really sick is just, like, leave them. It was the scariest thing.
That was the most pain I felt in my life. What it turns out it was I had an obstruction in my intestine. Anything I ate, it would be, like, because my intestine was obstructed, it would be, like, trying to, like, force it through, so I, like, had to stop eating anything solid.
This whole having Crohn's thing is Peter's new normal. He's used to it. I'm new to this, and it's a hard thing to get used to. You learn to recognize the signs that he's maybe feeling worse than he's letting on, but sometimes it's tricky.
I never know how bad he is, and then sometimes he just, like, is bad, and I just have no idea, and so I don't know. I just worry about, like, what I say to him, I guess, because I don't want to make things worse. And he messaged me and said, real talk time. Last night I was in worse pain than I've ever felt in, or than I've felt in months, and I'm super bitter right now, and I feel like shit. Mood's terrible, and the documentary is the last thing that I'm thinking about, so talking about it won't be very productive. I feel like I'm making it worse, and I feel like doing this documentary, like, I feel like I'm putting him through a lot of, like, extra stress that he doesn't need right now on his body, and it, like, so I just feel bad.
There's the big fears about health complications, but there's also the little fears. It's hard when plans get canceled over and over.
Peter's really sick and he can't come.
Who is?
Peter.
Oh.
Yeah. And I kind of don't know what to do. Like, it's like, I feel like I should almost go over there, but I'm also having a whole bunch of people here.
Oh my gosh, it's just breaking my heart.
I don't know, it's one of my fears for the future and stuff, just, like, him not being able to come to, like, just having to go through everything alone, you know?
Right.
So, I don't know. But
you mean you going to everything alone?
Yeah, I know that's a really stupid, like, useless kind of fear, but, like, I don't know.
I feel so bad. He just deserves to have a normal life. Be a normal young adult.
I know. Oh, such is life.
It's pretty shitty, is what it is.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you more.
I really love you, I'm sorry.
It seemed like a stupid reason to be upset, but it's, I don't know, I was really excited to have him here and have him meet my friends. It just sucks, like, knowing that he's sick and that he can't be here and that he wish he could be here so bad, because it's like he's like this young guy trying to live his life and he's losing it to Crohn's, and it sucks, and it sucks so much. I don't know what else to say. It just, I wish I could change it. I wish I could change it for him so bad.
It's hard to watch anyone suffer, but it's worse when it's someone you love. I've seen how IBD affects Celine's mom, Peter's sisters, their friends and loved ones. There's no cure yet, but that doesn't mean we can't do everything we can to make it even a little more bearable. I don't know what pains tomorrow will bring, when the medication will stop working, or even what new foods he'll have to cross off his list. But what I do know is that I won't let these things stop us. After all of the questions I've been asking Peter, he asked me a big one, and I said yes. I could tell that his mom was a bit scared. In private, she reminded me that I was signing on for a lot. I think she wanted me to reassure her that I was going to take care of her son. I know there will be good days and bad days, sometimes really bad days. I know it'll be emotionally and financially challenging often, but I also know these things in advance, and I'm more than willing to handle them. It would be a privilege to be his closest ally. The sun's coming out tonight. I think about it, and I feel alright.